Hi students, in the last two more videos we already explained the concepts of periodic table of elements, how to read element and what is a symbol, how the symbols are selected, what are the basis to select the symbols, that we already explained. In this video I am going to give an information, what is a molecule, what is an element, what is a compound, and what are the differences between molecules and compounds. Generally we already know hydrogen molecule, oxygen molecule, hydrogen chloride molecule, like that ammonia, different kinds of molecules we are going to listen in our chemistry part. How they are formed? See here, the hydrogen molecule is formed by the combination of hydrogen atom and hydrogen atom. Means hydrogen atom and hydrogen atom gives hydrogen molecule. That means molecules are formed by the combination of atoms. Molecule is formed by the combination of atoms. Here the two atoms are same categorized atoms. When compared to the same oxygen molecule, if you consider oxygen atom and oxygen atom. Nitrogen molecule, if you consider nitrogen atom and nitrogen atom. If we consider ozone molecule, ozone, oxygen atom plus oxygen atom plus oxygen atom, that means three same oxygen atoms are combined to form one molecule of ozone. Once if you observe this example, hydrogen atom and chlorine atom combined to give hydrogen chloride molecule. So here also molecule only, this is formed by the combination of different atoms. Means molecules are formed by the combination of either same kind of atoms or different kinds of atoms. Now they are called, that mixture is called compound atom. That compound atom is also called molecule. Compound atom, otherwise also called molecule. Atoms are group of atoms which are formed by the either same kind of atoms or different kinds of atoms is called as a compound atom. This compound atom otherwise also called as molecule. If you observe one more example here, hydrogen atom, oxygen atom, again hydrogen atom. Totally how many hydrogens? Two hydrogens and one oxygen. So it is called dihydrogen monoxide. If you observe one more example, hydrogen atom, hydrogen atom, hydrogen atom and one nitrogen atom. Totally three hydrogens are there. So, and one nitrogen. Now it is called nitrogen trihydride. Nitrogen trihydride, generally it is called as ammonia. So ammonia is a molecule. Molecule is a combination of either same kind of atoms or different kinds of atoms. Now, come to the definition of element and compound. See, element is also a compound atom, whereas well as compound is also a compound atom. But the difference is, the element is formed by the same kind of atoms. Compounds are formed by the different kinds of atoms. If you observe, hydrogen atom and hydrogen atom gives hydrogen molecule. It is an example of element. Hydrogen atom, chlorine atom, it is an example of compound. That the difference is, the compound atom which is formed by same kind of atoms is called element. The compound atom which is formed by two or more different kinds of atoms is called compound, where element is defined as the basic form of matter. It cannot be broken down into simpler forms by any chemical reactions. Means though you do many chemical processes, it should not be dissociated. For example, say if you use HCl, is there hydrochloric acid, you already know it is an example of compound. If you are going on heating or if you do some chemical reactions, it will be splitted into both hydrogen and hydrogen and chlorine. That means there is a chemical dissociation of atoms. In the case of compound, there is no chemical dissociation of atoms in the case of element. Element is a basic unit in the case of life. For example, say if we consider H2O, that is water, by passing electricity through it, it will be splitted into two gases, that is hydrogen gas and oxygen gas. Now we can say H2O is an example of compound. Whereas well as if we consider carbon, it is an element. Why? Because we can't broken down into the simpler parts by using any kind of the reaction. Now, okay, right? The definition of element was given by a scientist that is called Lavoisier. Who used the first term? That is Robert Boyle is the first person who used the term name element. See, these elements may be monoatomic. If single element is existed, that is called monoatomic. For example, say in the nature, all the metals are monoatomics. All the metals are monoatomics. All the inert gases are also monoatomics. Mono means single. For example, say if the element contains two atoms, it is called diatomic. Diatomic, oxygen O2, nitrogen N2, this is called diatomic. If the element contains three atoms, it is called triatomic. For example, say ozone O3. Tetraatomic, tetra means four elements. For example, say phosphor can be represented as P4. Polyatomic, more than four atoms are there, such elements are said to be polyatomics. Elements can be divided into either metals, non-metals and metalloids. These metals, metalloids and non-metals are played a very important role in the development of human life. If you observe Harappa Mohenjo-daro ages, they used copper vessels. And even if you see various such kind of the kingdoms, for example, Gupta kingdom, such kind of the examples, they used gold coins, they used copper coins, they used silver coins, as in the case of money. Means elements are placed a very important role. For example, some more examples, the crown which was used by the king is also made up of that. Why that much? In our temples also we are using different kinds of the elements. We are calling them as Pancha Loha Vigraham. That means it contains five kinds of the elements. Now let us come to compound. Compound is a pure substance, can be separated into two or more components by the means of chemical reactions. As I already given, H2O, water is an example of compound, hydrochloric acid, sodium hydroxide. We should know that in the nature, less number of elements are there. Lakhs and lakhs, millions and millions of compounds are there. More number of compounds are there. Generally, there also may be diatomic, triatomic, tetraatomic. Di means two atoms. For example, say HCl is a diatomic compound. HCl, hydrochloric acid, hydrogen fluoride, these are all diatomics. Triatomics, for example, say if you consider water, two atoms of hydrogen and one atom of oxygen is there, it is called as triatomic. tetraatomic four atoms are there. Polyatomic five more than four atoms are there. That is called as polyatomic molecule. So various differences that we can observe, differences between elements and compounds. The differences between elements and compounds, once if you see, all metals are monoatomic elements. All metals, here it will start from diatomic, means elements starts from monoatomic, whereas well as compounds are diatomic. Inert gases, what are they? Helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, radon. These are all the inert gases are monoatomic. Water, if you consider H2O, it is a triatomic. It is an example of compound. Why? Because here hydrogen atom is there, oxygen atom is there. I given some of the examples of diatomic gases: H2, O2, F2, Cl2, N2, Br2, I2. See, same atoms are there. And that will be two atoms are there. For that sake only same atoms are there. It is example of element. Two atoms are there. It is called diatomic. Triatomic here. NH3. One nitrogen atom. Three hydrogen atoms are there. It is an example of tetraatomic. Why? Because totally four atoms are there. Here triatomic gas is ozone. Like that. Here see, if you observe octaatomic element. Octa means eight atoms. Will combine to form one compound. Eight atoms of sulfur combined to form only one compound atom, that is called sulfur. It can be represented as S8.